building man. He goes by the name of Chuck Rofiwa.
Ah!
That was too much.
Say it again?
Rofiwa.
Please, save us.
Rofiwa.
There we go.
Rofiwa, yeah.
How you doing?
Good. I'm good, and you, man? How are you doing, man?
We're awesome. You just came from a performance at the SABC.
Yeah.
How was that?
It was dope. It was pretty cool.
Did you perform the jam?
Yeah. Of course. It's a jam. People love that jam.
When this is obviously your first single, I want to first go through the pronunciation of the word. This is the first single coming from your latest project.
Yes.
Ma.
So wait, this is Shivenda, right?
Yes, Shivenda.
Right. So fine, it's gonna be tricky for us because we're learning. We've never had a Shivenda rapper or MC in the studio before. But speak to me. Tell me something. You and Shaw have something similar in the sense that you guys both rap in your mother tongue.
Yes.
And when I say mother tongue, you can always say to me, but Dee, you have artists that rap in Zulu and Tswana. I say mother tongue in the sense that it's so rare that you hear someone rap in Tswana or Tshangane, because the majority language is Nguni, right? So wasn't that risky for you?
Yes, it is. It's still a risk, but it's a risk that I'm willing to take.
Yeah.
So the thing is, the music is for the people back home.
Mm.
It's a message. It's a lot of message that I'm trying to communicate with the people at home. So for me, that was more important than just trying to be in the lane. And the thing is, if you actually listen and feel the vibe, you're going to actually learn Venda. It's a dope language.
So when you say the people back home, right, and you're making the music for the people back home, you need to now paint a picture for me and explain to me like I'm a 5-year-old, because I've never been where you've been.
So
take me there. What is back home?
Back home, I'm from a village, Dori Dori, back in Venda.
Yeah.
Population of not more than 2,000 people.
Mm-hmm.
So information is very hard to get information. By the time you get a newspaper, it's 3 days old.
Mm.
In the past 5 years, we've been trying to get network, like just for you to go on Facebook.
Yeah.
You don't have that. You have to wait for like 30 minutes just to upload a picture.
Yeah.
Or read something that's very useful. So those people don't have information. For you to get fresh bread, you have to go like more than 67 kilometers. That's not even, so for me, those people haven't had any language besides Tshivenda.
That's all they know.
Yeah.
So the accessibility to certain things that we do have now in Joburg is it's non-existent, basically, right? So when you say you're making music for them, is it music in saying that, because I don't understand what you're saying, right? So is it music in saying that things are going to get better? Is it music in motivating them?
Yes.
Is it music, because I would imagine that then unemployment that side is the most scariest thing compared to how they...
Yeah. So the music is all about, I was one of the lucky ones to actually see beyond the village.
Yeah.
So the music is mostly experiences that I've seen to tell people that there is this that you can go to. We can go from here and we can get here because I've seen it and my life's experiences. So it's me telling them, yo, we can actually go and actually make our life better.
And then I want to ask with the first single, Rofiwa, like what is the Rofiwa rather? What is the message there that you were, because I can imagine you coming out as, okay, I'm gonna be, mother tongue rapper, and if I'm not mistaken, this is a whole new sound for you as well.
Yeah.
So obviously the first single had to be impactful in a sense that there was this particular message. What is that message?
Venda Rofiwa basically means Venda people are gifted.
Mm.
It's a song about being proud, about being who you are. You don't have to be Venda. It's just that I had to base it on Venda because I'm Venda. And I wanted my people to be proud of who they are. Never take second best. They can actually compete in whatever it is they have to do. And we have people doing that. So it's just a proud song. You have to be proud of who you are and where I'm from. That's why Mapungubwe and Rofiwa are tied together. Mapungubwe is where I'm from. The original kings of the Venda people are from Mapungubwe. So Venda Rofiwa was, we are very, very gifted people. And we still live the way we lived back in the day with respect and actually having all of those things. So it's just being proud of who you are.
you speak on being proud of who you are, right, as vendor people or as Africans in itself, but now the focus is more on vendor, right, because that's what your music is centered around. So you speak about being proud of who you are you then saying that, or let me not assume, so how's the culture then in vendor? Are the people there or the teenagers in vendor motivated, or are they typical teenagers where they are clustered with chaos? Where they go to school, and employment that we're speaking about is tremendous. How's the crime that side? Because when you say be proud of who you are, for me, I would take it as a lift off my shoulders and say, despite the odds, I am still me, and I can achieve what the song is telling me to achieve within my circumstances. So how's in the culture that side?
Well, the culture is getting to a point where, for me, when I looked at it, some people might have a different opinion on us. We're getting to a point where it's confusion.
Mm.
Because we're getting from a point where the elder people or the older people cannot talk with the younger people.
Mm.
So how I got information is I grew up with my grandmother. From generation, this is how they were supposed to do it. You need to find a medium to transfer the message to the next generation. My great-grandmother did it through stories. My grandmother used to do riddles. All the kids from the village would come through giving a riddle at the end of the week, you need to solve it.
Mm-hmm.
That's how information was transferred to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I looked at it and I looked at it, at the younger generation, what they like is music. I was like, the same things that I was given, which makes you proud of who you are. If you know who you are, if I know who I am, I will never want to hurt you.
Because
I know who I am and I know we are one. Why should I want to hurt you?
Mm.
That's eliminating crime. The reason why we have crime is people don't know who they are. All they want is money to create an image so that they can be accepted.
Mm.
But for me, it was like, okay, cool. We have all of this crime. People, yeah, we do have crime. But where I am from, you probably don't even see a police the whole year.
Yeah.
Because we are one community, we're a village. So everybody's like, okay, cool. Or maybe the police will come for somebody, domestic violence and some of that. But the people don't have information. That's the only thing. If people don't have information, it's because now nobody's transferring the old information, and even the new information is not getting to them.
But why do you think that people are not transferring the old information? Because it's so important for you as an African woman or man to know your roots and to know the stories of where you come from. So if the elders aren't doing that, they then can't send you, because let's say you were not told. Right? And we can't keep pointing fingers if we ourselves are contributing to the lack of knowledge. Because then what happens is that we are then creating human beings that are easily gullible and easily naive. And at the end of the day, as a nation, being South Africa, black people, we are then not growing because we are gullible. So irrespective of whether, because you would get a kid that is from Gauteng and they have all the information and all the knowledge, but the kid from Venda that lacks knowledge, but the adults are the ones that are adding to the lack of knowledge, right? So he then makes amazing music, but how is then his music going to be accessed if knowledge is a thing?
I want to tie in that question by saying yesterday at One Source, Shomo Josie was like doing her thing. And one thing I forgot about what they call that.
Spela,
yes. It's those little things just to, like, you know, keep yourself cultured. And this girl has been traveling to Afropunk. She's been going all over the world, and it's an authentic story that someone can take who doesn't know anything about the particular culture can absorb and say, okay, so what was it? Because coming to the foreign, Zulu is the only tribe or nation that exists within South Africa, and it seems like more and more artists now are telling authentic stories. Do you think that's where commercially South Africa is going to go, where you have to be telling an authentic story as opposed to telling a story that we've already heard?
Just tying into what you were saying about access of if these people don't have information, you gotta be authentic. I can't be talking about things that I don't know. You know, I grew up with my grandmother. She used to tell me everything about kings from very, very old generations. If you listen to my photo, it's all about that. And what actually made me do that was I went home and my niece failed last year. When I looked at the report, the only thing she failed was her own language, which is Japan. I'm right here making music in English and she listens to it and she understands it. I could have taken that opportunity to teach her about where she's from and understand who she is and be authentic while I'm still entertaining her. She passed this year.
Nice.
Because we made Chivenda cool for her. She never saw Chivenda as a cool language. You have to know how to speak it.
Exactly. You will never know that Zvenda is, or Chivenda is a cool language, or Stwana Kota Zulu, if your elders are not replicating that to you. So what he's doing is a beautiful thing. And I really like it that South Africa is moving, the music entertainment industry in SA is moving to that direction. Because you must remember that as black people, we're ashamed about who we are, our language, and that's where the twanging comes in, because we want to sound like the Europeans, and we seem to forget that the Europeans is who they are.
They
twang because it's their accent. Do you see it? Yeah.
100%, man. We're going to take a bit of a break, and when we come back, we're going to unpack more, and of course, just down the memory lane of the production that went into the music, unpack it, and of course, we're going to let you know where you guys can get it. Otherwise, this one is called Don Chuck. Do the right thing, man. Hit us up on social media at UJFM, hashtag the icon. Shh.